I mean, your first album came out, you know, it's been a few years and you've gone through so many things when, you know, now you're 24.
Yeah.
So what do you, like, how does that translate on your album and like your writing?
My first album actually, I didn't release out here. It was a regional record, so I mean, it only went into specific regions like UK, Germany, Australia. Now I'm releasing it worldwide, so it's kind of available for everybody to purchase. So I'm kind of treating this album like it's my first, because it feels like it.
Yeah.
It's exciting. I've got a lot of more acoustic live kind of instrumentation going on, the melodies.
And you kill it acoustic.
Thank you.
I saw you in Atlantic City. You did Body On Me. It was like just in a club, one song where we were in Ayala.
Just the guitar player.
You freaking went up there, and
thank
I was like,
you.
That's my girl. You killed it. And I've seen you do. When I was in Orlando, you did a quick show for us, and you did. I remember you covered Hey Ya, and I was like,
oh wow, yeah,
girl.
You were
she
there.
Was so good.
Yeah, I love Hey Ya. That's my favorite song ever. But it was. It's exciting because it's songs that I really love.
On Sunday, I was in Soho. My boyfriend lives in New Jersey, and he knows like how obsessed I am with your Adidas line.
Oh.
So we went to three different Adidas stores. I was like, I have to find this jacket
Thank
that
you.
Rita's wearing. Love, love, love your line.
Thank you so much.
How do you, I didn't know actually that you used to work at a sneaker store.
Yeah.
So is that like kind of where your inspiration comes and like kind of doing the whole Adidas thing?
I mean, working on the other side of it, actually like working on selling sneakers, you know, I would work on every weekend. It wasn't the best job in the world, but kind of you got to do what you got to do.
Exactly.
But
and now you've got your own lines. You're
crazy.
Like, oh.
It's just such a crazy world. It's so 360 because I went into the same store recently and I saw my sneakers on the shelf and I was like,
that
wow,
has to be like
insane.
A surreal moment.
Yeah, it was one of those moments. It's just those little things, like I definitely cried. I was like, this is crazy.
2012 was the first time that I met you in New York. It was like I think you were doing a showcase, and I think we've come across each other probably like four or five times since then, and you have been the same person that I met from back in 2012, and it's 2015.
You.
Even like when I was in Atlantic City,
yeah.
Like, oh, so I'm sure you were so tired.
Oh yeah,
but like, you just like gave
thank
me is like, let's do this.
Yeah, well.
So,
that's
and
nice.
I know that like to a lot of fans, like they're always following you and what you're doing. So, as a person that's you know followed by a lot of people or looked up to, how do you kind of you know keep your ground and like stay humble?
It's just about the company you keep. I think it comes a lot to do with the people you have around you.
Definitely.
And I think that's really the base of it. I mean, my sister's my manager.
Mm-hmm.
My parents definitely call me nearly every single day. I'm very blessed to have people that care about me around me. I mean, it's been a gradual build. Like my tour manager, Richard,
mm-hmm.
he's been with me since I started touring. My band members. I mean, I'm very loyal. You know, I find my crew and we grow together. And I think that's how you create a real environment.
And they're all rocking Adidas, I saw.
And I hooked them up with Adidas.
I know, they're part of the team. Well, good luck, new album in stores November 26th. Make sure you get it. Wiz, Chris Brown, and we got a song from Ed Sheeran on it. Which you guys made pizza the other night.
Yeah, I know,
I was
in
like,
Atlanta.
Amazing.
So random, but so fun.
Thank you for hanging out with us.
Hey, oh, hey, oh, I just wanna feel your body.